Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker is said to have many different surprises in this film by writer and director J.J. Abrams and Chris Terrio. This is Mike Zero. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, what's really exciting about this movie is that we do know that J.J. Abrams is introducing a total of 8 new characters in this story that will be used in a sense in order to evolve the characters of Rey and Kylo Ren, while also really honoring the legacy characters like Han Solo, Luke Skywalker, Lando, and even Leia, and let's not forget about Chewbacca. But I really want to focus on the character of Han Solo. Now, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this film, and when it all comes down to one of the concept art descriptions, this is where things begin to get very exciting for the character of Han Solo in Episode 9. Now, specifically, a description of both Rey, Poe, and Finn on board of the Millennium Falcon, where it's described that they are on course for the Exotic City, which is said to be a jungle world and location of the Dark Prince. It's said that while the Falcon is in hyperspace, both Poe and Finn are forming a plan, while Rey is exploring parts of the Falcon. It's said that Rey is sitting by the Dejarik board, where it's described that she begins to fiddle with the seat under, where it's revealed that a part of the seat opens up to a storage unit, where Han Solo left many of his personal belongings. It's described that Rey inspects the area and finds what is said to be Ben Solo's Jedi cloak that was left behind at Luke's training temple, where Han kept this hidden away on the Falcon that was given to him by Luke Skywalker before his departure to find the first Jedi temple. The cloak is said to be brown, very much like Obi-Wan Kenobi's, however has a different design to it. It's said that Ben Solo's Jedi cloak was left inside of his hut when he left the planet with a handful of Luke's Jedi students that Luke eventually retrieved from the hut, where Han Solo kept it a secret and stored it away on the Falcon. Another object that was stored in there was a Jedi figurine that Ben Solo played with as a child. It's described to appear as if it was handmade and is used as a small glimpse into Ben Solo's childhood. So I want to go over a couple of parts about this. Now, this is honestly great and a great tie-in also to the upcoming Kylo Ren novel that will explain Ben Solo's past and Ben Solo's childhood and a whole lot more about the early days of the First Order. In case you guys did not know, there is a novel all about Kylo Ren coming out in the future that most likely will tie directly into all of this. Now, what's really intriguing to me about Han Solo is that we do know that he's going to be used as a character in a sense where he will be a figurative ghost for, of course, Kylo Ren. But on the other side of things, there will be these little looming elements of the character of Han Solo just as this, where Han Solo kept, you know, elements of his own son on board of the Millennium Falcon, such as his Jedi cloak and or the figurine that Ben Solo used to play with as a child that was stored away underneath the Dejarik board, underneath that seat. So, to my knowledge, guys, I'm not even quite sure if this was ever known on the Millennium Falcon, if there was a storage unit underneath the seat right next to that checkerboard game, which, by the way, guys, is called a Dejarik board. I believe that's how you pronounce it. Very interesting thing about this movie is that we do know that a lot of little tiny Easter eggs just like this will be inserted into the film that are going to tie into other canon material. And what we mean by this is that it's going to tie into books, novels, comics, you name it, maybe even future TV series for all we know. That's really going to interconnect everything together here with Episode 9. So the one thing that I do want to go over is, why would Ben Solo have a Jedi cloak if he was just a quote-unquote Padawan, or a student, if you will, as Luke Skywalker calls them? So maybe this is Luke Skywalker's new way during his Jedi training temple, where Ben Solo had a Jedi Master cloak for some reason, because it's actually described to be very similar to that of Obi-Wan Kenobi's. Now, the one thing that I do want to bring up is this Jedi figurine that Ben Solo also once owned during his childhood, and this was actually stored away on the Millennium Falcon by Han Solo and kept a secret underneath that storage unit just underneath the Dejarik board. So what I like about this is that not only does it give us a glimpse into Ben Solo's past as a Jedi, but it also gives us a glimpse into his childhood of pretty much looking up to the Jedi, because he used to actually have a toy in a sense that was based on the Jedi. It's somewhat similar, if you guys notice, to what they did with Rey and how she has a figure inside of her AT-AT home, as well as, you know, Jyn Erso owning that Stormtrooper figure. You guys may have seen that in Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. It seems like that in the Star Wars universe, toys were actually a thing, and they're actually implementing that in an in-universe answer. So what I like about this whole entire situation here is that this is a moment in which the Falcon is on course for the exotic city. You know, both Poe, Finn, and Rey have time to kill, and this is where Rey actually explores parts of the Falcon in greater depth, and she actually discovers something very important and of value to Han Solo that she's going to most likely protect, and maybe she's actually going to use this in a sense in order to remind Ben Solo about his childhood and his father later down the road for the plot of this movie. So with that being said, guys, you know, what do you think about Episode 9 so far, about all of these different Easter eggs being implemented into the film? And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you also very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.